Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we are diving into a crucial aspect of Blazor development, that is how to effectively cancel background tags when a user navigates to another page. This is a common scenario that many developers encounter, and handling it correctly is essential to ensure a smooth user experience and to avoid unnecessary resource consumption. Imagine this. You are working on a Blazor application that fetches data from an API call. Your user navigates to a different page while the data is still loading. Without proper handling, that background task continues to run, isn't it? And in case it does that, it consuming resources and potentially causing unexpected behavior. But don't worry, there's a simple solution for this, and I am excited to introduce to you a small but powerful NuGet package that I have developed that is known as Background Tag Stopper. This package wraps the necessary functionality to easily cancel those background tags, making your Blazor application more efficient and responsive. So let me first introduce to you, without using the package, what else, or is there any way that you can do that without this package? Yes, you can. But if you want to be more flexible, then you can use the package to enhance your coding experience. Now let's see. So I have a solution here created, and I have an API and a Blazor assembly project added. I have configured the calls because in order for Blazor WebAssembly to interact with an API, you must register calls. So I've done that in the API. That is what I have done. So if I go to my API, I can see I've just added default calls in here, and after that I'm using the call. Now if I go to the web assembly tool, what I did was to just configure the base address with an API address. That is all I have done. And when you go to the default page of weather forecast, that is a weather forecast page component, you can see we're making a call. So instead of this Blazor assembly to get this from a static file, we rather want to get it from an API, so make it from weather forecast, and I'm just going to get it from that API that we have configured. So when you run this project together, you can see that this weather forecast, or this component, this Blazor application, it is getting the data from the weather forecast. Let's run this and check it out. So let's configure multiple projects so we can start both at the same time. So start and start. Let's start project together and check it out. Yep, and we can see that we have our WebAssembly, and also we have an API running, and that's the default one. And I believe you've done this before. So when you run this, you know we are having weather forecast as a default controller. Aside from that, when you go to, if I right click on this, go to inspect element, and I'm going to click on this weather forecast. And now from this network tab, go to weather forecast, and we're going to make a call which has a status code of 200. And now the address here, it is going for localhost 7106 weather forecast, and that is the address of the API. So this data is being retrieved from the database. That's great. Not the database, but the API. Yes. Okay, so now let's see how we can integrate this without using the package. How to do that? You know, you can manually do it in here, but this is going to happen in each of the components. Let's say you have three components, you have four components, the number of components that you have, if you want to cancel background tags as soon as user relocates or navigate to another page, then you have to implement this logic in all the various components. But when you use my package, it has and it encapsulates everything, and all that you do here is you use that package reference in your code, and that is all in the component, and you're good to go. Yeah, so I'll show you the two ways so that you can choose one for yourself. Good. Now let's first talk about the manual one. Okay, so without the package, how to go about that? So all that we need to do here is to create instance of cancellation token. So aside from that, you know, when you have a look with the page lifecycle event, dispose is the last stage of the event that the page go through before it dies out. So in that dispose, when the user navigates to another page, this dispose method gets called. So when this gets called, we want to set this cancellation token to cancel, so that it's going to cancel all the requests on that page. This is very simple. You see this? So let's see that. Now, first thing, we need to create an instance of our cancellation token in here. So you can see I have a CTS for the cancellation token. Now, I need to, in order for me to get the dispose method, you know, if I do override, I'm not going to have that. It's not like the unparameter set, initialize, and the rest. And the dispose method can only be acquired from the interface of iDisposable. So you need to implement it on top. So let's have iDisposable on top. And now when you have this interface here, we need to define the method. That's the implementation. And now we have our public dispose method. So with the dispose method, all that we need to do here is to cancel the token and now dispose the token too. So you can see we cancel it and now we dispose it. That is when the page is dying out. We do this. So all the subsequent requests whereby it has this as a parameter is going to also die out. This is a very simple one. You see? So now that we are done with this, we are not actually done, because when we run the app, although the token here is going to get cleared off, but still the call will be made, because we haven't passed on this token to the forecast. That is the endpoint call. So let's quickly do that, passing the CTS. And now in here, you know that this method can take in token as well. So passing the token, then get, we can extract the token from here. That's all that we need to do in here, and that is all. Very simple. Good. Now let's see. So if I run this application again, let's see. But before we do that, we want to extend the extension of this so that we can delay the call. We can do that by introducing delay. Okay, so let's delay. And now we can see that this is an async task. Then let's use action results. And maybe we can have our task.delay. So let's introduce await task.delay. And we are going to delay it maybe 5 seconds. So that's 5,000 milliseconds. And after that, we want to return this. So we can return OK with the data that we have. All right, so let's run boot again and I'll check it out. Okay, so we still have issue here. We are not done. You can see, is it expecting this? Yes, so let's do that. Okay, so the app is ready. Our API also working. If I may show you, you can see, yeah, it is working. Let's get it hidden. Now, I click on this. Let's go to inspect elements. Before that, I think I made a few changes here. Maybe I know you've done that. Let me show you. So if I minimize this, you can see from here, I forgot to bring this void. And I believe you've created that, isn't it? Good job. Now let's go back. So we have in here, let's go to the network tab. And I see what's going to happen. I'm going to click on this, which is going to take about 5 seconds. You can see time pending. As soon as I click on canceled, you can see it is here, it is canceled. It couldn't finish. Let's click on it again and I'll wait for some time. And within 5 seconds, this data should be retrieved. We have it. Now, if I click on the next one and I click on this, you see it gets canceled. So this is working. We can now cancel background tags if the user tries to locate to a new page. But maybe we know tags is being retrieved from the API, so we can check. We can use the interface or the event. That is when page is going to be navigated. We can check, maybe data has been retrieved, you want to still navigate? If yes, then we can do that. We can actually implement it to make sure to let the user confirm before navigating when data or when a task is being performed or when an API call is being made. Okay, but we are not doing that in here, and maybe you can do that or let me know. So maybe I have a time and do a simple video to show you how to also work on that. Alright, so let's say all the component that I'm going to create, I need to implement this iDisposable. I need to implement this. I need to create an instance of this CTS. You can say this is going to give us a lot of code, right? Another time too, good practice here is to simplify your code. make it small, okay, as much as possible, as much as you can. Do not repeat yourself all the time. When you have about 100 components, you need to create 100 instances of what? Cancellation token. So, do you have any solution in mind? Maybe you are thinking of creating this as a class. Yes, you can do that. And I've made it as a simple package, which wraps as a method and I return a CTS. So let's see how to do that. And you're going to love it. You know, in order to create component, there are two ways. You can just create a component of the same. You can create a class of the same component. Sorry for that. Okay. You can create a class of the same component. But when you do that, it must be partial class, because it is part of this component. They all have the same name. But in this application, you know, we're going to inherit this component from all the components that you're going to create. So we should not limit this to a specific class name. So let's make it general. Okay. So maybe we can have a general name given to that. Well, and in that, it should be a public class, and we can inherit it from all the other components. Let's see how to go about that. Now, in the solution, right click on dependencies. We are doing that from our Blazor application. Let's go to manage NuGet packages. But before that, you must stop the running first. Then manage NuGet packages. You know, I have 18 packages published now, and I think I have videos on most of them, how to integrate it. Maybe I'll put the video link in the description as well, so you can watch and I know how to use them. They're just amazing packages, simple ones, and they're interesting. So I'm going to pass in Netcode-Hub in here. And we're going to download or going to install one package. So we have the package in here, the last one, and that is the Netcode-Hub.packages.component.background-stopper. Background tag stopper. The name sounds weird, right? Never mind. Okay, so the name here is to let you know that it can stop background tags, isn't it? Good. So let's install this package. Now let's install this. That's the current version of 101. Let's apply this, accept it, and now we have the package installed. So now this package is successfully installed. There are various ways to verify. Let's see one here from my dependencies. We can click on packages. Then you see we have our package. Notice an API. So talking about the Blazor packages, and now we have it in here. I hope you've seen that. Yes. All right. So now that we have this, what is the next thing that we can do? We can just go in there and create a class for this. How do you do that? So in order to use that package in here, first of all, you can also do the same thing if you want to have your code base beneath your UI. You can do that. So let's first, we need to comment this one because the package also inherits from or this inherit this interface. So let's comment this. Then let's implement or let's add the namespace. So that's a reference. After doing that, we need to inherit from Netcode-Hub Tags Manager. So inherit from this, it's a class, and aside from that, you can just come in there and now let's duplicate this, let's comment this, and we can use component monitor. Now this method also going to return at the end is going to return cancellation token. Okay, so after doing this, we can then go ahead and comment. Since we are not having any interface in here, we can comment this. Now that we are done with this, let's also try this and see. So this token too, we can cancel or we can comment that. Let's reload this and check it out. So let's go to the developer tool, and here from the network tab, we want to access it. So you can see it is pending. Click on this and go to it is canceled. Pending. Go to home and it's cancelled. So this is also working. Now, what if in case you want to separate your code base from your UI, then you can also do that. So let's create a simple class from the Blazor. And now let's, it's a class. And now let's give it a name. So maybe this weather forecast. So let's say this is general Yeah, for now, let me maintain the general. And now, when I'm done with this, this class will inherit from the same Netcode-Hub Tax Manager. Okay, so Netcode-Hub Tax Manager. Now, this class has also inherited the disposable and also component base. So, you can use that. Now, since a general class for all components, you're going to make it as public. If not, if you are limited or if you want to create this to a specific component, then we can set it as partial. But for now, let's maintain this. So now that we have this, what can we do again? Let's inject our HTTP client and also this is our weather forecast. So let's add this. Now in order to do that, you can see you have weather forecast in here. So I'm going to copy this and after that, I'm going to comment this. Then in here, we're going to create a class. And now this class is a weather forecast. We create a lesson here. And now you can see when the page initializes, we are doing the same thing. So we are also calling component monitor. So you see that here we are separating the code base from our UI. So now that we are done with this, what else can we do? We can just go ahead and inherit from this general. And that is all. You can see this is very simple. Go to our weather page and our instead of inheriting, so here with all this component or this code section, we can comment it. Now from our this page, we need to also comment the HTTP client because we are not using that in here. After doing that, we need to inherit it. So inherit from general. Okay, so when you're doing that, it means this general here is inheriting from this Netcode-Hub Tax Manager. So we can remove this or we can comment this. And when we do that, I think we must have this inaccessible due to the protection level. Yes, you can see this is, let's say this, private. So let's make this as public. Yes. And that is all. So when you come back to this, I could see this size, it is inaccessible. When we stop this again and rerun it, this is going to, because this is public and it should be accessible everywhere. Okay. So weather forecast again, like you see, it is soft, isn't it? Great. Now you have nothing here again because the code base has been moved to a different class. And now we are using it, inheriting it from here. It's very simple. Let's save this one. Let's give it a try and check it out. So I click on this, you know where we're supposed to go. Network. And now let's see. So I click on weather forecast, 5 seconds, click on it and I can see it's cancelled. Again, home, and it is cancelled. Yeah, so this brings us to the end of today's lesson. We've seen how we can cancel background tags as soon as user moves away from that component. You've seen how to do that manually, and we've seen how to do that using the wrapper class that I created as a package known as the background stopper. Yeah, feel free to use it. All right, so that is it for this video. Thank you so much for watching this, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and now hit the notification bell for more tutorials on enhancing your Blazor application. And I'll see you in the next video.